Indian Air Force is on a massive overdrive to boost its bases along the eastern frontier with China. The massive upgradation plan covers 20 Air Force bases along the Eastern Command within a stone's throw from the volatile LAC. The plan involves new runways at over 10,000 feet, hardened shelters for fight jets, underground ammunition storage, improved radar coverage, and air defense systems at LAC, along with boosting connectivity and logistics. The mission is to be ready to face any potential PLA attack targeting India's air power and the ability to hit back at Chinese occupation forces in Tibet at a short notice. So is the Indian Air Force ready to take on Xi Jinping's PLAF? And which bases and sectors are the key focus of this upgradation program? The threat of an armed conflict along the Himalayan frontier cannot be discounted. China has a habit of poking India, either in the form of incursions at the LAC or in the form of diplomatic rows. Beijing last week could not digest a simple exchange between India and Taiwan and warned Delhi about Taipei's, quote, political conspiracies. In a fresh provocation, PLA dared to deploy its most advanced J-20 stealth fighter jets at the Shigatse Airbase in Tibet, just 150 kilometers from the Indian border in Sikkim. The satellite images of 27th of May show the biggest deployment of the J-20s near India so far. This indicates that China is clearly not backing down or considering easing tensions along the Himalayan border. According to observers, the Chinese PLA is building up and preparing for a potential global conflict. India is closely monitoring Chinese activities at the LAC, but what is India's answer to Chinese aggression? Its fleet of 36 French-built Rafale fighter jets are the tip of the spear, 8 of which participated in the United States' multinational exercise Red Flag, held in Alaska in May. 18 Rafale or one squadron are part of the burgeoning Eastern Air Command, which is spread over the vast skies of 3 lakh kilometers and 12 states. Boosting Eastern Air Command capabilities has become the top priority of the IAF. Apart from that, in another significant development, the Indian Air Force is constructing a second runway at the strategic Leh Airbase in Ladakh. There are two major reasons to build a second runway in Leh, located at 10,682 feet. Firstly, the decision was taken given the increased number of operations by fighter aircraft and attack helicopters along the line of control. And secondly, the number of civilian flights has also increased, due to which the need arose to offset this traffic. This will be the first high-altitude airbase in the country to have two runways. Ever since relations with China nosedived after the Galwan Valley clashes, which resulted in the loss of lives on both sides, the Leh Airbase has been a crucial part of the fighter jet operations. Remember, 68,000 men were airlifted by the Indian Air Force to and from the airbase to bolster India's position in the sector in 2020. Rafale, MiG-29, Sukhoi 30 and Apache have all been operating from the airbase, which is capable of night operations. So how else is India countering Xi Jinping's PLA? Satellite imagery of the Chabua Airbase, known to be IAF's crucial facility under the Eastern Command, revealed the scale of renovation and construction at this base. The key base lies near China and is also home to Sukhoi 30 MKI fighters. Bird's eye view of the airbase shows construction of additional taxiways, hardened shelters for fight jets, and underground ammunition storage. In a potential standoff with China, the improved runways and taxiways can sustain high-tempo operations and could be used for drones as well. Just 23 kilometers away from China's boundary at an altitude of 13,700 feet, a 2.7 kilometer long runway at the Naomi Airbase will be completed in October this year, enabling the C-130J Super Hercules to operate from the Naomi airstrip. Construction of significant infrastructure includes hangars, the air traffic control building, and hard standing, which are hard surface areas for parking vehicles and aircraft, is still on, and completion is expected by the end of 2025. To support the forward deployment of troops and always be a step ahead, the IAF also deployed its Mi-17 medium-lift helicopters, CH-47, the Chinook heavy-lift helicopters, and AH-64E Apache attack helicopters. Due to China's increasing military presence along the LAC, the infrastructure upgrade contract has been expedited and placed in the high priority category. The 1200 crore rupee project with Tata Power SED for the modernization of airfield infrastructure was signed in 2020. It consists of 37 airfields of the IAF, Indian Navy and the Indian Coast Guard that have been identified for this upgrade. In 2023, India also unleashed the S-400 air defense system capable of targeting Chinese J-20 stealth aircraft by deploying them near the eastern border. The Triumph interceptor-based missile system can destroy incoming hostile aircraft missiles and even drones at ranges of up to 400 kilometers. As Indo-Chinese relations have hit an all-time low, bolstering surveillance capabilities along the border has become a priority for the Indian Air Force. Indian manufacturers Larsen & Toubro will supply high-power radars and close-in air defense weapon systems to the IAF. This is being done to strengthen India's radar coverage and surveillance capabilities in strategic areas along its eastern border. But the big question is, will these infra upgrades give the Indian Air Force an edge over the Chinese PLA? Leave a comment, hit the like button and subscribe to InConnect News.